an unforgiving frozen forest the size of the lower 48 states, a hostile landscape where few Russians dare to live. But one American calls this barren land his home. He's rolled the dice, leasing $500,000 state-of-the-art logging machines that put old Russian Cold War equipment to shame. The cutting season is already underway. Sean is 2 weeks behind. This is his last chance to secure land. If he can't make a deal with the colonel, Sean's dream of starting a Siberian logging company will die an early death.
It's really good quality timber, really good.
Sean likes what he sees, but this is Siberia, and the colonel has never put his trust in an American before.
На Шона я как бы ставлю очень много.
Sean can start logging, but only on a small block of trees. If he can impress the colonel, Sean can earn the full contract.
We're basically been given a little trial piece. We've got to do that well. If not, then the big opportunity up the road, that's not going to be ours. That'll be someone else's. So, you know, I got to go with it.
Okay. Хорошо, ну давай. Да, хорошо. Мы пилим.
It's the middle of winter, dark and 40 below.
Kind of a little intimidating.
Different.
Well, where's Sean? Didn't he know when our plane was landing?
Sean's American team, Brandon, Zach, Jared, and Josiah, have been traveling for 50 hours.
I think I'm 20 to 30 times farther than I've ever been away from home, and it's all 100% new to me.
Whew. That's a blast of cold air.
The guys are in unfamiliar territory, and Sean is nowhere to be found. He sent his right-hand man, Vitaly, to take them to a rented cabin on the outskirts of town.
No Sean.
Cold out here. Some guy says he knows Sean Van, and I have no idea where the we are going tonight. I want to know where the Sean Van's at.